Hi everyone, I'm Shripal Bhavsar. I'm a radiation oncologist with INTEGRIS Cancer Institute. I wanted to take a couple minutes to relay some guidelines for our cancer patients with regards to the COVID-19 pandemic. COVID-19 is a clinical syndrome caused by the SARS coronavirus 2. It stands for Coronavirus Disease 2019. As far as those guidelines, it's all prevention. Prevention is the name of the game. In radiation oncology, we talk about radiation safety, and the main principles of radiation safety are going to be time, distance, and shielding. And I think those translate very well to mitigating the preventing contagion from an infectious agent. So minimizing time of exposure, maximizing distance from exposure, and shielding, which would be gloves and masks. So what we want to do is when we're going out, we want to minimize how much we're going out. Essential things only, going to the grocery store for food, going to the doctor's office, just kind of those essential items. When we are in the presence of others, we want to maximize that distance from them. So that's the whole social distancing thing, keeping a 6 to 10 foot distance from everyone. If you're coughing, sneezing, doing that into the crook of your elbow. And shielding would be wearing a mask, right? So wearing a well-fitting cloth mask. There are lots of directions on how to make one of those. If you've got a surgical mask, you can wear one of those. An N95 is probably overkill, but if you got one, go ahead and knock yourself out. I think that's important for patients, especially those who are in an immunocompromised or suppressed state. Meaning, you know, you've had chemotherapy or radiation treatments or really any of those things, including other risk factors, heart disease, lung problems, diabetes, all of the above. Also good to wear gloves in those scenarios, especially if you're out. Very, very important to avoid touching your face. When you touch your eyes, nose, mouth, those are ways that we are taking virus and putting it into our bodies. So it's very, very important to avoid touching your face. Your hands can be as dirty as they possibly want to be, but if you never touch your face, you're not putting anything in your body. So always important to try to avoid face touching. As far as the mask guidelines, I think, and compulsive hand washing, that's important for patients as well as their caregivers. If you're home as a patient, but your caregiver is out doing those errands for you, it's important that they're following those principles too. That's the best way to keep all of us safe. We're working as a community here. Other important things, wash your produce. That's kind of a thing we should have been doing all along. I think a new thing would be packaged goods. Wipe them down before you bring them in the house. Let them sit for 5-10 minutes so they can disinfect, you know, if you're using Lysol wipes or the like, and then stock them in your home. So those are things we can do. It's gonna be really confusing. A lot of the symptoms of coronavirus are, you know, fever, shortness of breath, cough, sometimes diarrhea, loss of your sense of smell. There's a whole bunch of them. You don't have to have all of them. Presentation has been very mixed to this point, but that can be really confusing when you're having cancer treatments because you could be having diarrhea due to treatments. You could be having shortness of breath, especially if you've, you know, a lot of our lung cancer patients will have underlying emphysema and lung problems. So a lot of the stuff is very difficult to figure out. So I always think it's best to operate on the assumption that you have already got exposure and you're trying to minimize exposing anyone else. And if everyone's doing that, we're all, you know, not spreading it to each other. So that is the goal of all this. Prevention is the name of the game. Obviously, for concerns regarding ongoing treatment or follow-up, call your oncologist's office and see what we can do. Follow-ups that don't, you know, just have routine lab review or reviewing films, you know, CAT scans, MRIs, things like that. A lot of that we can do through telehealth now. We can kind of do a face-to-face video conference for that, and that will help quite a bit in kind of keeping you at home, not having you to come out here and brave the world. you know, those are a lot of those things that can be done now. So it's worthwhile to call in and check in and say, hey, is this something I can do via a telehealth or virtual visit? In some instances, if there's something new going on, new pain, bleeding from something, you know, that's important to tell them, and you know, they may need to get you into the office or into the hospital with those things. So, you know, keep that communication open with your providers, and just, you know, stay safe and compulsively hand wash, wear a mask, and just stay away from everyone. Stay at home. Most things are just not worth it. All right. You know, call us if you need any more answers. All right.